Leslie Kimiko, your classroom dance teacher here, today with a fun lesson on plate tectonics. We're going to learn about the different layers of the earth and how they move around one another. Sound like fun? All right, let's begin. All right, let's begin by defining some terms. So everybody up, stretch, you've been sitting for far too long. Ugh, shake it out, good. Put your hands over your head like this. Stiffen your forearms and your fingertips, and everyone say the word crust. One, two, three, crust. Good. The crust is that rigid outer layer of the earth. Doesn't move much. When it does, we'll talk about what those terms are in just a bit, but that crust is a rigid outer shell like the candy coating on an M&M. Yeah? We've got the crust of the earth. Underneath of the crust, we have a rocky layer beneath the earth's crust that we call the mantle. So wiggle your fingers like this, a little lower than you put your crust. Wiggle your fingers and say the word mantle. One, two, three, mantle. Excellent. The mantle's the rocky underlayer, and you can see from my fingers, has a little more potential for movement than that rigid outer crust. Getting closer to the center of the earth, the temperatures are rising, and the next layer down is called the outer core. Can you tell from my hands whether or not the outer core is a solid or a liquid? Yeah, it's a liquid. The temperatures are so hot that that rock has turned molten. And when we get all the way to the middle, all of those pressures from the outside condense to form a tight inner core. So I want you to bend your knees and squeeze everything as tight as you can and make a little ball and say inner core. One, two, three, inner core. Nice. So let's put all those layers together, starting with the outside. We've got the crust. Next level down, we've got the rocky mantle. You've got it. The next layer down, we've got the outer core. Good. And all the way at the center, we've got the inner core. Let's go back out from the inner core to the outer core, a little higher, to the mantle, and all the way at the top we've got the crust. Good. Let's play a little game. I'm going to give you a word, and I want you to show me in space where it is and what it is. So let's start with mantle. Right, that's this one right here. Excellent. How about the inner core? Yeah, solid, dense, small. Good. How about the crust? That's the outside, nice and rigid and stiff. Good job. And what about that outer core? Where is it? Yeah, just next to the inner core, that liquid hot outer core. No more help from these words. All on your own. Outside in and inside out. Let me hear them while we do them. One, two, three. Good. One, two, three. Yeah. One, two, three. Outer core. One, two, three. Good. Back from the inside. One, two, three. Inner core. Good. One, two, three. Outer core. Good. One, two, three. Mantle. One, two, three. Crust. Nice job. All right. On to plate tectonics. So plate tectonics are the fancy words we use to describe the ways that the Earth's crust moves around one another. So, why does it move? Well, all those pressures building up from the inside, remember that hot outer core? That heat is trying to escape. It comes up through the rocky mantle and it tries to escape out of the Earth's crust. But as we found out, that crust is rigid and stiff. Now, if I'm waiting in the lunch line and I'm feeling liquidy and loose and easy and someone bumps into me, woo, no big, woo, again, no big, woo, this is a crazy lunch line. But if I'm liquid, I have lots of options for how to move. But if I am stiff and rigid and I am waiting in line and someone bumps into me, I'm gonna move as just one piece. And that's what we talk about when we talk about plate tectonics. Those plates are the rigid chunks of Earth's crust that move together as a solid unit. And when they run into another plate, or when they run away from another plate, or when they slide against another plate, we get all these fancy terms. And let's go over some of them now. So two plates coming together, bring your hands from the outside and bring them together and say the word converge. One, two, three, converge. Yeah, when two plates come together, we say that they converge. If they start to move away from each other, we say that they diverge. So let's try, start with your hands together. Bring them apart and say diverge. One, two, three, diverge. Good. We've got converge, We've got diverge if they slip against one another, if they slide by each other, like you're in a really narrow hallway and you're trying to get by somebody. They transform. They're not turning into something else. They're just slipping beside one another like so. So let's put those together. We've got converge, diverge, transform. Good. And then if one dives underneath of another one, so here's a plate and here's a plate, they come together and one takes a nosedive towards the center of the earth. We call that subduction. So I want you to take your hands, dive them underneath, and say the word subduction. One, two, three, subduction. You've got it. So all together, we've got converge, diverge, transform, subduction. The hands will help you remember what those actions are doing. So let's put them all together again. Ready? And converge, diverge, transform, subduction. Yeah? Two more times and it's yours. Converge, diverge, transform, subduction. One more. Converge, diverge, transform, subduction. That will be stuck in your head, I hope. The good thing about learning while we move is that it takes all this information and it plugs it into the back of our brain where we can store it for a long time and use it whenever we want. So, how did that go? Converge, diverge, transform, subduction. Now, when those things happen not so easily, we end up with earthquakes, volcanoes, all kinds of stuff. Let's talk about the 1964 earthquake in Alaska and what caused it. Two plates converged together. One started to dive under the other one. What's that called? Subduction, right. So one started to dive under the other one, but it got stuck. Yeah? It got stuck, and as it got stuck and continued to try and dive, eventually it had to shake itself loose. Well, that shaking creates a great big earthquake. So those subducting plates got caught, and when they shook themselves loose, boom, there went Anchorage. 1964 earthquake caused by a subduction that was shaking itself loose. So all those terms again, what were they? Converge, diverge, good. Transform and subduction. Excellent. Quick note for teachers, if you're enjoying this activity and you want to explore it further as a class, divide your class into teams. Assign each team a different earthquake and have them research how the plate tectonics were involved in creating each event. The kids can act it out through movement, and remember, it doesn't have to include sound. We can disconnect the sound from creating the movement and enjoy a fun activity where we're learning while we play. All right, let's review everything we've learned so far. So let's start with the layers of the earth, starting with the outside and working our way in. We've got that rigid outer layer, or the earth's crust. You've got the next layer down, that rocky layer is called the mantle. Good, let me see those hands. The next layer down, we've got that liquid, molten, hot outer core. And all the way at the inside, that dense little ball from all the pressure is called the inner core. So let's go back up. Inner core, working our way out to the outer core. Next is the rocky mantle and that rigid crust. Let's put them together. Crust, mantle, outer core, inner core, inner core, outer core, mantle, and crust. Again, crust, mantle, outer core, inner core, inner core, outer core, mantle, and crust. You've got it. Let's talk about plate tectonics. What are all the terms we learned today? Starting at the outside, those plates converge. Good. They diverge. What's this one? Transform. And when they dive under one another, that's called subduction. Put them together. Converge, diverge, transform, subduction. Again, converge, diverge, transform, subduction. Again, converge, diverge, transform, subduction. If you have a test, you can dance in your seat. Converge, diverge, transform, subduction. Again, converge, diverge, transform, subduction. Faster, converge, diverge, transform, subduction. Slow-mo. Converge, diverge, transform, subduction. Nice job, everyone. Oh, I've had so much fun dancing with you all today. I hope you've had half the fun that I have. I'm Leslie Kimiko, your classroom dance teacher. And if you want more of this awesomeness, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, Your Classroom Dance Teacher. Find me on YouTube or send me an email. Let me know what it is that you'd like to have turned into a fantastic movement activity. yourclassroomdanceteacher@gmail.com. Send that to me. Let me know who you are, where you're writing me from, and what do you want to dance about today. All right, I think that does it for me today. Remember, I'm Leslie Kimiko, your classroom dance teacher, and I look forward to dancing with you all again real soon. Until next time, America, happy dancing!